We discussed constructing a quadrilateral if we're given lengths of both the diagonals and lengths of three sides. Now what if we're given angles? Along with the lengths of a few sides, we're given angles too. Let's try that. Here's an example for you to try. Observe that we're given length of three adjacent sides and included angles. Remember, we'll be always given sufficient data for construction. First, let's draw a rough sketch of what we'll be constructing. Let's assume BC to be the base. It's 4.5 centimeters. Angle B measures 110 degrees. So we draw a ray like this with the same measure. Now AB is given to us as 3.5 centimeters. So we mark A here, assuming AB measures 3.5 centimeters. And since angle C measures 80 degrees, we draw a ray like this. This angle is 80 degrees. And now we mark 4 centimeters here. This is point D. We get a rough quadrilateral ABCD. And that's exactly how we will construct the proper quadrilateral. We'll start by making a line segment and subsequently construct angles to finally form a quadrilateral. We shall start with constructing the base BC as 4.5 centimeters. From the point B, we need to make an angle of 110 degrees. Remember that 110 is not a standard angle and thus needs to be constructed using a protractor. The line segment AB measures 3.5 centimeters. Thus, from point B, we mark 3.5 centimeters here. What does this give us? Yes, we have our side AB now. Make a note that if we are given standard angles like 30, 60 or 90 degrees, we will need to draw them using a compass. We're now left with side CD and side AD. Now what do we do next? We have the measure of angle C. It measures 80 degrees. So we draw the angle from point C using a protractor. We use a protractor as it's not one of the standard angles. Now looking at the question, I want you to guess what we should do next. We are given data for side CD, that is 4 centimeters. So we can keep the compass at point C and mark 4 centimeters here. This gives us side CD. Observe a constructed figure and you'll find that we have sides AB, BC and CD. We are just left with side AD. Do we need the data for side AD? Not really. We already have points A and D on the plane. Thus, by joining these two points, we get a quadrilateral ABCD. Just remember that we will always need the included angles in this case. In the next lesson, we'll learn about constructing a quadrilateral if we're given three angles and just the lengths of two sides. It's just a small variation in the problem we discussed above, but it's definitely interesting. Watch the next video to find out more.